The building behind us, the IS4L building, will allow our scientists to do work under the highest level of containment. This means that we can work on pathogens such as foot and mouth disease, African swine fever, African horse sickness, in a building that has layers of protection before anything could happen in terms of release of virus to the environment. It's important to have these very high engineering standards in the building. We have the highest level of control systems. We have the best type of sealability of the building that's available for current technology. And I think in this building here, we've actually incorporated some world-leading design features. We need high containment facilities to ensure that the work that's done on pathogens, both the existing ones that we have as part of our research portfolio, but also have the preparedness for what might come next. If you look at what has happened in the world in the last 10 years, 80% of all new pathogens that come into existence and that have affected human population have all arisen out of animals. And that means that probably that same process will continue to occur. And this laboratory means that we have the best facility available to be able to answer those questions when they occur. One of the key systems that we have in the building is our air handling system. This is a critical part of the engineering standard that we have in the building. It consists of air intake into the rooms that we then have graded pressures inside the room such that if anything happens inside the room, the virus or any pathogen is then extracted out through a series of other filters. And what we have in terms of our secondary monitoring system is the ability to be able to interrogate this system in real time. And this is important because we want to know if there is a slow failure of any system, let alone a rapid failure. But if there's a slow failure of a system, then we can intervene and we can do something about it well before there is any potential release of virus to the environment. The first part of the development program is to replace our existing infrastructure here with a brand new laboratory. This is currently under construction and will be completed in the early part of 2014. At the same time, we have a second phase development program, which is about moving our avian diseases program from Compton to Pirbright. This will consist of a number of new animal research facilities and laboratories that will ensure that by 2015-16, we will have everything consolidated on one site and we will have brand new infrastructure that will see the Institute's work through for probably the next 15 or 20 years. The work here done at the Institute for Animal Health will benefit global food security. It will help in terms of the science that we do to provide the best basic research and the best development into vaccines that we could possibly do to ensure that the UK will be protected from incursions. But the added benefit is that this work will help many developing nations who have quite severe problems with animal disease. And so the diagnostics work here and combined with the vaccine development work here should in effect make sure that those economies are better suited to be able to feed themselves in the future and that we have a better animal health system overall globally.